Kentucky is home to many country music artists like Tom T. Hall, Billy Ray Cyrus, and Chris Stapleton, just to name a few. But for many people, when they think of musicians from Kentucky, many think of Loretta Lynn. Loretta Lynn was born on April 14, 1932 in Butcher Hollow, Kentucky, in an old coal miner's cabin to Clara Marie and Melvin Theodore Webb. Lynn was the second child born of eight children. In January 1948, she married Oliver Lynn a few months before his 16th birthday. A year later, they moved to Custer, Washington for Oliver to find better work opportunities. For the next few years, he worked in logging camps while Loretta did a few odd jobs and took care of her four children. Following her husband's encouragement, she began singing at local venues and clubs, which soon caught the attention of Zero Records. The record label released her first single, I'm a Honky Tonk Girl, early in 1960. To help promote the song, she traveled all over the country to country music radio stations, trying to persuade them to play it. As she was traveling, she ended up in Nashville, Tennessee, where Loretta began singing on demos recordings for Teddy and Doyle Wilburn's publishing company. In October 1960, Loretta had her first performance at the Grand Ole Opry. 2 years later, she scored another big hit with Success, which made it to the top 10 on the country charts. She definitely didn't shy away from her more controversial material, as shown with her song during the Vietnam War, Dear Uncle Sam, singing as a terrified lover of a draftee who she didn't want to see sent to war. In 1966, Lynn had her highest charting single to date with the number 2 track, You Ain't Woman Enough, and in 1967 she got her first number 1 hit, Don't Come Home A-Drinkin' with Lovin' on Your Mind. That year she was named Female Vocalist of the Year Award by the Country Music Association. Because of her at-the-time controversial lyrics, 14 of her songs were banned from the radio, Fifth City being one of them, and another was The Pill, which was a protest song for women's reproductive rights. She said in an interview, "If I had had the pill back when I was having babies, I'd have taken them like popcorn." She had already had 6 children by the time birth control pills started coming around. Teaming up with Conway Twitty, Lynn won her first Grammy Award in 1972. That same year, she won Entertainer of the Year prize at the CMA Awards, making her the first woman to do so. Conway and Loretta both won the CMA Vocal Duo of the Year Award for 4 consecutive years, from 1972 to 1975. In the 1980s, as country music began to change, Loretta's popularity was growing smaller. She didn't appear as often on the country charts and instead was a spokeswoman for a shortening company and had appearances in TV shows such as The Dukes of Hazzard, Fantasy Island, and The Muppet Show. She was inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame in 1988. Soon after, she began scaling back her work to care for her husband. She did make time to work with Dolly Parton and Tammy Wynette on the 1993 album Honky Tonk Angels. Lynn's husband died in 1996, marking the end of their 48-year marriage. A few years later, she struck up an unlikely friendship with Jack White of the White Stripes. Lynn performed with them in 2003, and White ended up producing her next album, Van Leer Rose, in 2004. Van Leer Rose injected new life into Lynn's career. The pair won 2 Grammy Awards for their work for Best Country Collaboration with vocals for the song Portland, Oregon, and for Best Country Album. Following the success of Van Leer Rose, Lynn kept busy by playing numerous concerts each year. Lynn was honored with the Grammy Lifetime Achievement Award. In 2013, she received the Presidential Medal of Freedom from Barack Obama. In March 2016, she released Full Circle, which was produced by her daughter Patsy and John Carter Cash, the only child of Johnny Cash and June Carter. The album debuted at number 4, returning Lynn to her familiar place at the top of the country charts. On May 4th of 2017, Lynn suffered a stroke at her home and was hospitalized in Nashville. That October, Lynn made her first public appearance since the hospitalization, when she inducted longtime friend Alan Jackson at the Country Music Hall of Fame. In January of 2018, it was announced that Lynn had fractured her hip in a New Year's Day fall at her home, and a few years later, Lynn died on October 4th, 2022 at her home in Hurricane Mills, Tennessee, when she was 90 years old. For many people, especially those in eastern Kentucky, such as Van Leer and Johnson County, Loretta Lynn is still a household name, and thousands of people still listen to her music. This is Larry Rice for CVM 320, signing off.